real device. It should have a real path as a simulated object, and then you can.
Well, yes, I think it was.
We started with an under-tapped model to calculate electrical calorie coefficient, and we found it extremely simple. A very quick calorie coefficient is proportional to the product of temperature, polarization, and dielectric susceptibility. But, and then we didn't see NMD, and it worked very well. But this was done assuming equilibrium conditions. But now what is super nice is you have non-equilibrium conditions. So do you know if this model still works or not? If your alpha electrical version is simply proportional to temperature, polarization, and dielectric susceptibility in non-equilibrium condition.
Are you suggesting
that
you
study for us? You have everything on it.
Well,
I'm just wondering if it's.
Well, it's a good question. So, probably, yeah, we have to try to see. Yeah, we didn't look at this possibility yet. So.
So you mentioned reversible heat and irreversible heat.
Yes.
So can you explain more what do you mean by irreversible heat? That which come from this? By the way, you apply it here. How do you quantify it?
Okay. So okay, so reversible and irreversible heat, right? So the one which we, so reversible heat, so when you apply electric field up there, so the one which you return back from the thermal bus, right? So the irreversible one, which when you release, you don't get it back in our simulation.
Okay, let's
thank
all the speakers in the session.